6:30 this evening, a young girl is removed from a family in Dublin. The child is now in care after Gardaí intervene and take her from a Roma family. Also on the programme, the origins of the investigation. A message to a TV3 Facebook page sparks the inquiry.
But for the majority of people, I'm sorry, but they are suffering. And suffering in silence because nobody's paying attention to what they're saying.
Senior citizens take to the streets over budget cuts.
The meeting in the room was, you know, was horrendous.
And dishing the dirt, Fergie reveals how the relationship with his captain soured. Good evening. A young child is in care this evening after Gardaí intervened and removed her from a Roma family in Dublin. The girl had been living in a house in the Tallaght area of the city. Well, our reporter Marie Mulcahy is outside Tallaght Garda station for us this evening. And Marie, what can you tell us about this case?
Well, Colette, what we know now is that this case is an international investigation, Interpol and Europol, trying to help Gardaí identify this child, establish where she was born and where her birth was registered. This investigation was launched after specific information was given to Gardaí. They went to a house, a unit from the Child Protection Unit here at Tallaght Garda station where I am. They went to a house in this area at around 4:30 yesterday evening, and we understand they spent about 2 hours with the Roma couple, who insisted a blonde-haired, blue-eyed child in the house was theirs. The couple said she was born in 2006 and was 7 years of age. Gardaí said they simply weren't satisfied with the information provided by the family, with the documentation provided with them. And on that basis, they took the child and placed her in the care of the HSE, where she remains this evening. Now, Gardaí say it is, of course, an emotional time for the young girl who has been taken from the people, I suppose, she understood to be her family. We understand she speaks some form of Roma dialect, and specialist interviewers are being brought in to speak with her, but that process hasn't started yet. The child is in good physical condition. There's no sign of a medical condition or any danger to her health. But we understand now as well this investigation is likely to go into the area of genetic testing. There'll probably be some DNA sampling done in the coming days and longer interviews with the Roma couple in question. But as to whether Gardaí go public for information or issue a picture of this child, that is yet to be decided. Of course, the law in this country protecting the child's identity, and any decision on that or any review of that will depend on the progress in this investigation.
Marie, thank you for that. Well, this investigation originated through TV3, prompted by a message posted on the Facebook page of the Paul Connolly Investigates programme. Well, Paul joins me now in studio. Paul, can you explain your connection to this case?
Sure. It was yesterday morning. I received an email from a researcher and assistant producer here in TV3. She had helped me set up the Paul Connolly Investigates Facebook page and had an email alert system set up to her email address when a message came into that. So she spotted this email, realised and had the wherewithal, thank God, to send it on to me. And it was very, very specific, which made me worry. It had the name of the child, a very clear description of the child, the address of the child. So as is protocol, obviously, here in TV3, I then forwarded that information onto the Garda press office, and from there it really kicked off. The Child Protection Services in the Tallaght branch of the Garda station were on to me almost immediately. We were in contact then for the remainder of yesterday, because the anonymous source, the girl that had tipped us off through that Facebook page, she hadn't included a number, so we had to get that off her. We managed to get our hands on that about 10 o'clock last night. I contacted the Gardaí, they told me they'd be in touch, and here we are.
Paul, there's obviously a lot of sensitivity surrounding a case like this.
Indeed, Pabbi Point have released a statement just in the last couple of hours, rightly stating that we shouldn't jump to conclusions. Nobody has been charged or arrested, Colette, as you both said. There's no proof as yet that the young girl isn't related, and that obviously will be pending that DNA testing. And specifically in the statement, Pabbi Point have stated that they are concerned about a witch hunt ensuing here against what is a vulnerable community in the Roma people, especially in light of recent international incidents of a similar nature. New information is coming to light literally every hour, so we'll fill in the gaps.
All right, Paul, thank you for that. Well, today's developments come as attempts continue to trace the biological parents of a young girl found at a camp in Greece. Today, a family in the United States made contact with the Greek authorities.
Could this be Maria? The parents of Lisa Irwin, who vanished in October 2011 from Kansas City, have contacted Greek authorities in the hope she may be their daughter. An age-processed image of how Lisa may look now bears a resemblance to the girl who was found in the Roma camp last week. Theirs is one of around 8,000 inquiries that have been made about the child since she was discovered by police. Interpol are assisting a worldwide hunt to trace the real family of the child, who is believed to be around 5 or 6 years old. We do know she is not the biological daughter of this man and woman. The couple are being detained on charges of child abduction, but their lawyer says that the child was given to the parents immediately after her birth. She says that, with regard to this case, this is not a kidnapping, this is not an abduction. The biological mother gave up this child due to economic reasons. Police have raided dozens of Roma settlements in Greece in the last few weeks. There is concern about how the Roma community are being portrayed.
Our attention is to take good care of this kid and to take care of any crimes happening in this country coming from Roma or elsewhere. But we're not prepared to see another pogrom in the name of law and order against Roma lifestyle.
There have been calls today in Greece for an emergency nationwide investigation into birth certificates issued in the past 6 years. Authorities are trying to establish if welfare fraud is a factor in this case. The child at the centre of this worldwide investigation remains in hospital. She is expected to stay there until experts conduct further tests to determine her origins. Lisa McNally, The 5:30.
Senior citizen.